Hello guys, this is the another lecture on simplex method. In today's lecture, we will discuss a minimal linear programming problem. That is a problem which is minimized Z, and we have to solve this by simplex method. So the problem is minimum Z is equals to x1 minus 3 x2 plus 2 x3. Subject to condition 3x1 minus x2. Plus 2x3 is less than equals to 7, minus 2x1 plus 4x2 is less than equals to 12, and 4x1 minus 3x2 minus 8x3 is greater than equals to minus 10. x1, x2, x3 is greater than equals to 0. So to solve it, what is the first step? The first step is problem should be maximized, but this problem is minimized. So first we have to convert this minimize problem to maximize problem. And how to convert? By multiplying minus 1. So right here, since problem is of minimized, so to convert it into maximized, we multiply by minus 1 to both sides and take minus z equals to z. So what it will convert? This will convert into max z is equals to minus x1 plus 3x2 minus 2x3. Now the second step is all bi's must be positive. That is, right hand side of the inequality must be positive. But in this particular problem, the third inequality contains negative right hand side. So we have to convert this negative right hand side into positive right hand sides. And how to convert? By multiplying minus 1 to both sides. Since third inequality contains negative bi, so to make it positive, multiply by minus 1 to both sides. So what we get? Minus 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 8x3 is less than equals to 10. Now the third step is change inequality to equation by introducing which kind of variable? Slack, surplus and artificial variable. But in this particular problem, all the inequalities are less than equals to. So in this problem, we only add slack variable. So we can write only change inequality to equation by introducing slack variable. So the first condition is 3x1 minus x2 plus 2x3. So what we have to add? We can add x4 as a slack variable, which is equals to 7. In the second equation, minus 2x1 plus 4x2. Now again we have to add one slack variable, which will be equals to x5, because x3, x4 already used. So new slack variable is x5. And for the third inequation, now this is not the inequation, this is our inequation now. So what we have to add? x6. That is minus 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 8x3 plus x6 is equals to 10. And right here, x4, x5 and x6 are slack variables. So, now, minimum z is converted into maximum z, and all inequation are converted into equations. Now, we have to write a revised simplex problem so that we can make a starting simplex table. So, the revised problem is, max z dash is equals to minus x1 plus 3x2 minus 2x3, and the cost of slack variable in the objective function is 0. So, plus 0x4 plus 0x5 plus 0x6. Subject to condition 3x1 minus x2 plus 2x3 plus x4 is equals to 7. Minus 2x1 plus 4x2 plus x5 is equals to 12. Minus 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 8x3 plus x6 is equals to 10. x4, x5, x6 are slack variable, and x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6 greater than equals to 0. So this is the revised problem where we have to apply the starting simplex table. Now this is the starting simplex table. Here first three and last one are fixed, and the middle number of columns are variables, depends on the number of variables. So in MaxZ there are total number of 6 variables, so there are 6 columns are there representing x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6 as y1, y2, y3, y4 and y6. You can write in the bracket x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6. Now we have to enter all the data from revised problem to in the starting simplex table. So we have to write all the coefficients of each equation in the all three rows. Now the coefficients of the first equation are 3 minus 1 2 1 3 minus 1 2 1 0 0. The coefficient of second are minus 2 4 0 0 1 0, and the coefficient of third equation are minus 4 3 8 0 0 1. Now see what are the XVs. XV represents the BIs, and the BIs are 7 12 10, and the CJs are the coefficient in objective function, that is the coefficient in maximum z dash. The coefficients are minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0, 0, 0. Now, there is no need to show this revised problem because all the data are inserted in the simplex table. So, we can erase it from here. So, now what will be the BVs? That is basic variables. Basic variables are those variables which form unit matrix in the simplex table. Now see, where is the unit matrix? Generally, slack variables form unit matrix, and in this particular problem, slack variables are forming unit matrix. So, the elements of main diagonal represents it. That is, the corresponding variable will be written in front of that particular main diagonal element. That is, for this main diagonal element, there are x4 is a variable. So, write x4 here, same as x5 and x6. And CV is the cost variable. that is cost of the basic variables, and the cost of basic variables is represented in the CJ, that is 000. So the value of maximum Z dash, which is equals to CB into XB, that is the product of these terms. Sum of the product of these all, CB into XB, which is equals to 0. And already you know that if max Z equals to 0, then all CJ is equals to delta J. That is, we can copy all CJ into the delta J. Means minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0, 0, 0. Now what we have to do? We have to identify ICD, incoming vector. And how to identify? We have to find out the most positive delta J. What is the most positive delta J? This is 3. So this is the column corresponding to this, or the variable corresponding to this maximum delta J, is the IC, incoming vector. So what we have to do? We have to divide this XB, that is, we have to find the minimum ratio. So we have to divide this XB by ICB, and ICB is Y. So we have to divide XB by Y2 by the corresponding elements. The first element is minus 1, and we cannot divide by the negative, so leave it as dash. Divide this 12 by 4, 4 3 is 12. Divide this 10 by 3, that is 10 by 3. So what is minimum? 3 or 10 by 3? The 3 is minimum. 3 is minimum. So this is OG, outgoing vector, that is X5 will be removed and X2 will take place. And the intersection of ICB and OGB is the key element. So put a square box on it. So now this step is completed. Now moving on to the next step. The next step will contain X4 as it is, X5 is removed, and X2 take place. So X2 and X6 as it is. The cost of these basic variables can be identified from the CJ every time. So the cost are 0, 3 and 0. Now what we have to do? We have to divide entire key element row by the key element. So what is the key element? 4. So divide entire row except CB. We cannot divide CB. So divide this entire row by this 4. So what we get? 4, 3 is 12, minus 1 by 2, 1, 0, 0, 1 by 4 and 0. Key element columns, all the element in key element columns will convert into 0. And what? How to convert into 0? Because we have to make it as a unit matrix part. Because all the elements which are in the basic variables must be formed unit matrix every time. So for the unit matrix, all the elements will convert into 0. The column remains as it is, which has 0 in the key element row. Means key element row mein jo bhi 0 hai, wo wale column as it is copy ho jayenge. So ye first, that is 2, 8, minus 2, this one 0, 0, 0, and this one 0, 1, 0. And the remaining elements will be found by the formula. So what is the formula? Position of element is equals to element minus product of diagonal upon key element. So first we have to find the value of this 7, this particular place element. So what is the original element at this place in the above table? The element is 7. And what is in front of this 7 in T element column? Minus 1. Write T element and write the element in front of T element in the column where we have to find the value. So this is 12. That is, we have to find this 7. मतलब क्या है कि उस एलिमेंट को लिखिए जिसको फाइंड आउट करना है, उसके सामने की एलिमेंट कॉलम में जो भी नंबर लिखा है उसको नोट कर लीजिए, फिर की एलिमेंट ऊपर है तो ऊपर लिख लीजिए, नीचे है तो नीचे लिख लीजिए, फिर की एलिमेंट के सामने वाला एलिमेंट लिखना है उसी कॉलम का जिस कॉलम में आप फाइंड आउट कर रहे हैं, ठीक है। तो हमें ये फाइंड आउट करना है, ये की एलिमेंट है, तो ये दोनों क्या बनाएंगे, डायगोनल्स। सो 7 माइनस 12 इंटू माइनस 1 अपॉन 4, 4 3 या 12, तो माइनस माइनस प्लस 3, तो 7 प्लस 3 10, सो दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 10। नाउ फाइंड दिस पर्टिकुलर एलिमेंट, व्हाट इज रिटन ओवर हियर, 10। व्हाट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ दिस 10 इन द की एलिमेंट कॉलम, 3। राइट की एलिमेंट एंड द इन फ्रंट ऑफ एलिमेंट, नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस 10, सो दीज आर द की एलिमेंट्स। So 10 minus 12 into 3 upon 4, 4 3 is 12, so 10 minus 9, that is 1, so this is 1. This we have to find, what is written over here, 3. Write the element in front of this 3 in the key element column, write the key element and in front of element minus 2. So this we have to find, so 3 minus, minus 2 into minus 1 upon 4, so 2 to here, 4, so 3 minus minus plus plus minus minus 1 by 2, that is 5 by 2. Now this we have to find, what is written, minus 4, write in front element in key element column, 3, and this remains as it is, that is minus 4 minus minus 2 into 3 upon 4, 2 to the 4, minus 4 plus 3 by 2, that is minus 5 by 2. Now we have to find this element, what is written here, minus 1, 3, 4 and minus 2. So minus 1 minus minus 2 into 3 upon 4, 2 to the 4, so minus 1 plus 3 by 2, that is plus 1 by 2. Now find all these three elements. Similarly, we can find it. I am writing directly, that is 0 plus 1 by 4 and 0 minus 3 by 4. 0 minus 3 by 4. So this step is completed and the maximum z dash is 9. Now see whether there is any positive delta j exists or not. If exists, then we have to move further. If does not exist, then the step is completed. Now there is one delta j which is positive, so we have to move further. Again, identify most positive number. The most positive delta j is 1 by 2, so this is ICV. So what we have to do? We have to divide this XB by Y1. So divide this 10 by 5 by 2, this will convert into 4, this is negative, leave it, this is also negative, leave it, so this is the OGV outgoing vector, that is x4 will be removed and x1 will take place. So the intersection of ICB and OGV is key element, so put a square box on it. Now make a new matrix, that is x4 will remove and x1 take place, x2 as it is and x6 as it is. Put the all cost of these basic variables from the CJ, the cost is minus 1, 3 and 0. Now what we have to do? We have to repeat the above process, that is we have to divide the entire key element row by the key element, so divide it, this will be 4, 1, 0, 4 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 10 and 0. key element column, all the elements will convert into 0. All the elements containing 0 in the key element row remains as it is the column, that is 100 and 010. And the remaining elements will be defined by the formula. So we have to find this. What is written over here in the previous matrix? 3 is written. What is in front of it in the key element column? 1 by 2 minus. Write key element, that is 5 by 2. Write the element in front of 5 by 2 in the column where we have to find the value. That is, this is the key element, this we have to find. These are the diagonals. So 10 minus, so 3 minus 10 into minus 1 by 2 upon 5 by 2. That is 3 minus minus plus 2, that is, it is equals to 5. Similarly, we have to find the next element, that is, for this 1 minus 5 by 2, 5 by 2 and 10. So 1 minus 10 into minus 5 by 2 upon 5 by 2 cancelled, 1 plus 10, that is 11. Now for this element 0, 2, minus 1 by 2 and 5 by 2. So 0 minus minus 1 by 2 into 2 upon 5 by 2. That is minus minus plus 2 by 5. Similarly, 8 minus 5 by 2, 5 by 2 and 2. 8 minus 2 into minus 5 by 2 upon 5 by 2. That is 8 plus 2, which is equals to 10. So for this, this is minus. What is written over here? Minus 2. What is in front of key element column? 1 by 2. Key element. And the element in front of this key element is 2. That is minus 2 minus 1 by 2 into 2 upon 5 by 2. That is minus 2 minus 2 by 5. That is minus 12 by 5. Similarly, we can find all these 6 elements. That is, I can write them directly. So the value is 0. The product of these two terms is minus 1 by 2 and minus already, so plus 1 by 2 upon 5 by 2, that is 1 by 5. Similarly, this will be positive and 0 minus 1 by 5. This will be 3 by 10 minus 1 by 2. And the last one is minus 4 by 5. See, all the delta j are either 0 or less than 0. So the steps are completed. Optimal solution exists. So the maximum z dash is minus 4 and plus 15. So this will be 11. So since all delta j are less than equals to 0, so optimal solution exists. And max z is equals to minus 11. But in the problem, this was minimum z. So we have to find the minimum z. So max z dash will convert into minimum minus z. So this is plus 1. So minimum z is equals to minus 11 at x1 4, x2 5. x1 equals to 4, x2 equals to 5 and x3 is equals to vanished or equals to 0. So this is the complete solution of this kind of minimal linear programming problem. Hope you understand the content of this particular lecture. If you like this lecture, then like, subscribe and share my channel. Thank you.